A very good afternoon to all the parents and grandparents present here on this pleasant November afternoon. On behalf of all of Class 7s, I would like to extend a very warm welcome to each and everyone present here.
It's an esteemed honor to be standing in front of such an impressive assembly on this wonderful day of Jashneer Bachpan, where we at Delhi Public School celebrate life and learning. Variety is the spice of life. Life without feasts and celebrations is charmless and lifeless. So, it's true in the case of school life. Jashneer Bachpan, a festival of childhood, not only provides a stage or a platform for the students to showcase their talents, but it also helps them to achieve a holistic approach towards learning. Life brings tears, smiles, and memories. The tears dry, the smiles fade away, but the memories last forever. These are the memories that we shall always cherish when we walk down the memory trail.
Now, we would like to express in words all that we have accomplished and cherished through our session. We would like to share some of the momentous achievements of our present session, 2018 and 19. We signposted off our events calendar by having a class assembly by each section. These assemblies were designed at bringing out our inherited capabilities. Our teachers ensured 100% capacity. Since the school follows a cohesive approach along with thematic teaching to keep abreast with the global world of tomorrow, hence, we the students of Delhi Public School Pune were given occasions to participate in various academics as well as co-curricular competitions.
To build up on our poise and charisma, we had weekly competitions every Thursday. These competitions provided us a platform where we could exhibit our brilliance. Our teachers also inspired us to participate in various co-curricular activities so that our unfinished shoulders are able to take on the confidence.
Poster making, brainstorming, storytelling, essay writing, tableau and social movements, quiz on noise pollution, quiz on institutions regulating noise pollution, and many more. The list is endless.
It is often said, today a reader, tomorrow a leader. With this motto to believe, we are citizens of tomorrow. And to promote wholesome reading habits among children, the READ program was conducted every Monday. Students were greatly benefited by this activity by reading books like Ek Chuppi Jagah, Mitti Ki Gaani, Matilda, George's Secret Key to the Universe, Ek Nara Bole, Kathavali, Monster Calls, and When You Reach Me.
This year we had ISRO Science Exhibition, where we learned about science, space, astronomy, timeline of ISRO, and satellite launching. A science exhibition was held on the topic sustainable energy within the school campus. The children poured out their heart and soul to express their gratitude to the soldiers on this Independence Day by writing beautiful letters to them.
A social science exhibition was organized to showcase the work of students based on a vast range of topics such as the early men, their settlements, a comparison between past, present and future settlements, Vedic life, solar system and many more.
To inculcate the traditional values in our students and to revive the dwindling spirit of Indian artistic and cultural heritage, we have joined hands with Spikmatic, a non-profit voluntary movement for the promotion of Indian classical music. As part of this initiative, we were fortunate enough to witness an astounding Carnatic musical recital by Sri Sikkil Govil Gurjar.
Ouch! My ears hurt. Why do the neighbors play such loud music? music. I have not been able to concentrate on my studies since morning. How will I prepare for tomorrow's exam? Oh God, someone help me. Oh God, when will the loudspeaker stop? I'm having a splitting headache.
Of King Louis XIV. There are kings, queens, and of course the Unicorns, and so on.
sure you all are excited, aren't you? We're also equally excited to present the story before you. So let's start the magic and watch the drama unfold in front of our eyes.
The young Dhatriya travels to Paris with a letter of introduction addressed to Monsieur Dhatrivya, captain of the king's musketeers. At Dhatrivya's house, he meets Athos, Porthos, and Aramis, who will soon become his firm friends. However, before their friendship can be confirmed, they each challenge him to a duel. Fortunately, before any of the duels can take place, the three musketeers and Dhatriya are confronted by men from the cardinal's guards. There is a fight which the musketeers win, and when the king hears about the fight, he makes Dhatriya one of the cardinal guards, though not yet a musketeer.
Meanwhile, Cardinal Richelieu is planning to trap the queen and make sure that the king has proof of her infidelity with the Duke of Buckingham. She has foolishly given this rare diamond studs, which the king had previously given to her, to the duke as a sign of her affection. The cardinal has arranged for Milady Day of Winter to steal some or all of the pins. She manages to steal two.
And thus, Richelieu is sure that the queen will not be able to wear the full set of 12 in time for the dinner and the dance. However, Dhatriya gets the pins back from London to Paris just in time for the main event. Here, the king and the cardinal are desperate to find protection in Huguenot, stronghold of La Rochelle, and with the help of their four friends, they succeed. Dhatriya is then summoned by the cardinal. He fears for his life, but returns to his friends with a piece of paper confirming him to be a lieutenant in the king's musketeer.
We now present before you Judge Bashpan.
And sets off in pursuit. that your junior and that your senior enter.
What you command then, son? To go to Paris?
Yes, father. You have taught me the art of sword fighting well. Now, I want to become a musketeer in the service of the king and queen of France.
Then go, my son. I have taught you how to handle a sword. You've got two strong legs and a wrist of steel. Give this letter to Monsieur de Trivier, the captain of the king's musketeers. He will then agree to test you for suitability to be made a musketeer.
Thank you, father. I promise not to let you down, but bring glory to thy name.
Then leave, my son. Do not hesitate, or you may lose the chance that fortune in the wisdom offers you.
And so,
Tantra sets off for Paris. However, I need a letter to the Trevia. It was more difficult than it was thought. So Dante was a hot-headed and impetuous young man.
What a funny man and a funny horse! Oh, such a steed that my lungs could bleed like a butter, please!
A young man with an unusual horse!
I say, sir, you, sir, were hiding yourself in the shutter. Yes, you, sir, tell me what you're laughing at, and we will laugh together.
I was not speaking to you, sir.
But I was speaking to you, sir.
This horse has decidedly, or as my opinion is you, a buttercup. It is a color very well known in botany, but till the present time, it is very rare among the horses.
A buttercup? That's true, Mr. Rochefort.
You dare laugh at the horse, but you dare not laugh at the man.
I may laugh at whomever I please, but it is I who do the laughing.
The beard is moody, yellow in hide, without a hair on his face, but not without wind gags on his lips. Has a ridiculous appearance. Oh, such a steed.
I'm a Gascon. Nobody laughs at me. Turn in and cheat your sword, sir.
Very high place. Did you search him?
Yes, I did. I found a letter. It is the Trevier.
I know who he is. So the Trevier sends a boy to do a man's job.
What should I do with him now?
Let him recover and go wherever he wants to in the flea-bitten nag of his.
As you say. Oh, a beauty.
Ah, lady. You have done your turn up.
Find your mate a bird fight. You hear my news.
What is it?
Wait, first tell me, who is this?
It seems that the royalist has sent this lunatic to do for me.
A fine face. Pity, he must die so young.
A flower there is on marble skin.
Why don't you kill the stranger?
There's time for that now. I'm dying to know your news.
The English nobleman. The Duke of Buckingham is here in Paris.
The Queen won't be foolish enough to meet him.
Buckingham Lord, sir, and see him.
Anything's possible if that is the case.
What about him?
It's his lucky day and so ours. The Cardinal must know at once.
Ah, my precious letter! It's gone! It has been stolen by the men in bunk.
Oh,
Thus, giving an opportunity to the many posterity.
to rid him about flirting with a married woman.
Oh, what a lad! London fool! Have you no manners by? I must try. Athos, teach you some manners?
And how does Athos propose to teach me what he himself is lacking so much?
Meet me at noon behind Luxembourg and I shall show you.
I will be there 10 minutes before.
And who is this clumsy dirt?
I am D'Artagnan.
And I am in a great hurry. Meet me behind Luxembourg at once and ask for Porthos. You shall pay for this.
Another one?
I must say, you are very strong,
Aramis. So what did you do? How did you catch that man?
Actually, he wanted my sword. I refused to sell him my sword, took him by his hair and dangled him.
Allow me, monsieur. Your kerchief. Ha 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 ha. Lady's handkerchief? What? It's been a lady's handkerchief, my dear Aramis. And were you flirting with married woman?
You deceived me, sir. The kerchief is not mine.
But I saw you drop it.
If you call me a liar, young man, I shall be obliged to cut you into pieces. Meet me behind Luxembourg at 2 noon precisely.
Oh, what have I done? Got 3 needles in the morning, 3 musketeers. I'm in a great trouble.
So, an exciting business of sword fight is going to take place. But they're intervened by the cardinal's faithful guards. All 4 together fight with the guards. D'Artagnan dispatched of Jussac himself, and the others dispatched the rest, killing 1 with Jussac grievously wounded.
Oh, monsieur, you are punctual. However, I asked 2 of my friends to be my seconds.
We wait for them by all means.
You did hurt me terribly.
I is not right that I should fight you in your weakened condition. I have a recipe for a balsam that is excellent, and it will make you fit in 3 days. Then we can fight.
Ah, but during his banned in 3 days, the news of impending duel will get to the cardinal's guards, who are ever on the lookout to meddle with the musketeers. Ah, here come my friends now. At least one of them.
What? This Porthos should be one of your seconds.
Why not? Here comes another.
And Aramis your second also.
Why not? We 3 are inseparables. In fact, we are called the 3 inseparables.
What? Is this the man you fight?
Why not?
Because I fight him also.
But only at 1.
And I fight him also.
But only at 2.
It is hot, but I must fight in my doublet, for I feel my wounds start to bleed again, and I do not wish to trouble you with the sight of blood that is not drawn.
I would be distressed to see the blood of a brave man such as you drawn for any reason. I shall fight in my doublet also.
Come, come, stop the flattery. We are awaiting our turns.
Thank God!
Await your turns.
If we were to see fighting among ourselves, we would not interfere. Lead them to their fighting and you can enjoy a good spectacle.
Duty before everything else. Seize your swords and follow me or you are under arrest.
Monsieur, we'll have to accept kind invitation. However, monsieur, the 3 we are forbidden.
We must charge you then.
There are 16 of them and we are 3.
We are 4. I may not wear your uniform, but my heart is as sharp as yours.
What is your name, my brave fellow?
I am D'Artagnan. Well, gentlemen, what have you decided?
We shall have the honor of charging you.
One for one! One for all!
Yeah.
sends him to a man who gives him a room and rent. This man introduces Batanion to his wife. They fall in love at the very first sight. Here, Cardinal is working on his plan to create a rift between the king and the queen, as the queen has total control over the king. He wants to break her power. So, he sends Milady, or Lady de Winter, to steal the prince that the king had given the queen as a present and which she subsequently gave to the duke as a sign of her love.
Monsieur, my friend is also saying, you have lodgings to rent? Are you going to room for me, monsieur?
Yes, I have your man. Come, I'll show you. But the rent is payable in advance.
Well, I'm in short of money at the moment.
No worries, sire. You can pay me later. This is my wife, Constance Bonacieux, the seamstress to Her Majesty, the Queen.
Good morning, gracious lady. I'm back in here. Come in search of a lodging.
We surely have enough for you, don't we?
Yes, we do.
The Queen still dominates the King, George Cole. Her power must be broken.
You are clever agent, Your Eminence.
I've already sent for her. Ah, milady.
I'm at your service, Eminence.
The Queen's intrigue with the English Duke of the Kingdom must be exposed.
The Queen confides only in her seamstress, Constance. Abduct her and I make her talk.
See to it, Rochefort. Get back, Constance. Waste no time.
Yes, sire.
Rochefort, comes to this house to kidnap Constance.
Madam, is that Constance?
In the name of His Eminence, I arrest you.
Why? What have I done? Let me go ahead! Nothing here!
Oh, Dathanya, you saved my life. Allow me to thank you.
Madam, I have done what any gentleman would have done. You do not need to thank me. Those men were the agents of the Cardinal, and I'm sorry to say, your husband was taken by force to Bastille yesterday. Those men who just fled away will return with reinforcements any time now. We must leave.
Yes, we must run. They tried to kidnap Constance.
The Cardinal is plotting against Her Majesty. Clearly, we must warn every musketeer in Paris. Let's go.
All forward and follow!
The Queen is soon advised of drawing on and against the desire to see her wearing the diamond studs that he had given her. But there was one big problem. The Queen had given the 12 diamond studs to the Duke of Buckingham. In her memory, the Cardinal suggests the King to host a royal ball where the Queen would wear the 12 diamond studs.
Oh, Constance, I'm in trouble.
What is it, my Queen?
The Cardinal has organized a diamond dance. He prevailed upon the King to have me wear the diamond pins he gave me as a gift.
Well, that should be easy. Allow me to be of service to Your Majesty. And we also love and soul.
Unfortunately, no. The pins are in England.
In England? How did they come to be there?
Ah, Constance, I gave the Duke of Buckingham as a sign of my affection.
Do not worry, my queen. For I know of a man who can get them back.
You do?
And who might he be? His name is D'Artagnan. He's incredibly brave, very talented, and totally devoted to his kingdom queen. He'll surely do anything for you.
Then make haste, Constance. Give him whatever man he needs. I must have all the 12 pence back, for the king has requested I will a full set.
Now, this business of pence was all the doing of the Cardinal, who wanted to drive a wedge between the king and the queen. Anticipating that the queen might send an emissary to fetch them, he sent Milady or Lady de Winters to steal them. He gave Milady a letter pardoning her in advance for killing D'Artagnan, for she was a skilled assassin.
Month's time had passed after D'Artagnan's distinction at the duel, where he sided with the musketeers against the Cardinal's guard, after which he accomplished several other feats.
D'Artagnan was by now much feared by the cardinal, for his exploits with Athos, Porthos and Aramis showed him to be not only courageous but also witty and intelligent.
It means you must follow me.
Two forges?
or wherever you think you shall be healed.
In service of the king
or the queen, for having us sworn to protect and serve the king or queen.
What? What was that? Since when did the captain of the musketeers give a letter of absence without the musketeer asking for it?
Since the musketeer gained friends on his behalf.
We all are going on a campaign.
A campaign to which country?
I don't know anything about it. Ask D'Artagnan.
To London, gentlemen.
What are we to do in all of London?
That I am not at liberty to tell you, sir.
But to get to London, money is needed and I have none.
Nor I.
I have here 300 pistols. We shall take 75 each, which shall be enough for us to reach London and return.
You mentioned...
Go ahead, as we hold them.
said, locating the Duke was an equally easy task for Batman. Everyone he asked knew the Duke's location and provided the right directions. But before that they all could reach Buckingham, the lady reaches first and joins the Duke for the dance. In the middle of the dance, she quietly slips away, sneaks into the Duke's room and steals two diamond studs.
Madam, Countess de Winter, it's a pleasure to have you here. Yeah.
May I have the pleasure of dance with you?
It's an honor, sir.
Urgency. Her Majesty has sent me here to request you to return the casket of diamonds that she gave you. Here is the letter signed by Her Majesty.
Certainly, my dear fellow. I have it here. Take them to her with my deepest love.
Someone has stolen them. It must be Cardinal's agent.
It is Lady de Winter. She was at ball to which I wore them and she saw them. She is an employee of the Cardinal.
We have time. The ball is on Monday.
No fear, my dear child. I know a jeweler who can make identical studs and soon replace them. Send for my jeweler.
The Duke placed an embargo on all ships leaving England so as not to let Lady de Winter deliver the pin she stole to the Cardinal. With special permission and a special route, complete with change of horses set up for him, D'Artagnan thus reached Paris in time for the dinner and dance. In the meantime, in Paris.
Here, Your Eminence, the pins.
Only two.
I was almost caught, Eminence. So I could manage to steal only two.
Ah, well, two will do to unmask the queen.
Thank you.
the port set out to find the best route to reach Paris. They are attacked by English army. The four fight against an English army and win the battle. The queen is tense as the ball was tonight, and she cries as she would be exposed to the whole of Paris.
The ball is tonight. It's hopeless. The D'Artagnan won't come back with pins or time. I'll be shaved.
It is time, Your Majesty, to get ready for the ball. Trust the Arnaud. They'll soon be here with the pins.
Your Majesty, the diamond pins, all of them.
Except the queen's hands, the Arnaud. You saved my office.
Authorizing whatever I think is necessary. fleet of France.
Will your lordship permit me to say something concerning my enemy?
Do you also have enemies?
Yes, the first busybody goes by the name Onantia, and another whom I hate even more, the wretch D'Artagnan.
I see no problem with that. I'll give you a signed pardon in advance for the murder of D'Artagnan. Good day, milady.
A stove pipe is a useful appliance.
Indeed, it carries the heat from room to room, thus removing the need of a separate stove in each room.
Oh, it carries more than heat, Porthos.
What do you mean?
It carries voices.
Voices?
It was not merely to hug the fire that it stood by the stove. The pipe carried voices from the ladies' room.
When I heard the cardinal address her as my lady, I stayed to hear the whole conversation.
And what did you learn?
That my lady is to travel to London to meet the Duke of Buckingham.
Indeed! And what is she to convey to the Duke? Or is she to murder him?
She is to tell him that if he supposed the Huguenots at La Rochelle, his affair with the Queen will be conveyed to the King. This will ruin her. He enumerates various proofs that he has gathered. They appear to be solid proof. He has witnesses, documents, and turncoats.
And what is to be her reward?
Carte blanche on the death of D'Artagnan.
His death.
Ah, when Milady hates, she hates with a vengeance. She has obtained from the cardinal an advance pardon for killing him. What exactly the pardon says, I don't know, but I do know that the cardinal has written one.
And what if the cardinal asks you about your whereabouts?
Tell him I do not like one or two things our innkeeper has said, and suspect an ambush on the road. Tell him I have gone to scout the road. I should then openly go and tell his valet a few words to this effect as well.
We shall do so.
Porthos was not scouting the road. Instead, he waited for the cardinal and his companions to leave and circle back to the inn. He told the landlord that he had forgotten an instruction to Milady and had gone to deliver the instruction. He was there without question to her chamber.
Who are you? What do you want?
I'm sure Milady recognizes me. Have you forgotten your husband?
The Comte de la Fere.
In person, back from the dead. You thought me dead, but as Athos, I was able to hide myself and this simple musketeer. But I know every one of her actions. Wife of mine, wife of which she marries the Dementor.
You know nothing. You are bluffing.
I know that a slip of diamonds on the prince's costume. I know that a sent us poisoned wine at La Rochelle. And I also know that when sudden an advance pardon for killing D'Artagnan.
You are a Satan.
I may or may not. Now listen. Do what you want to the Duke. He is an Englishman and no friend of mine. But do not put a single hair of D'Artagnan's head.
He has insulted me. He must die.
Lady, this instant you will deliver to the Pope by the right of your side. Or upon my soul, I will blow your brains out.
Take it and be damned.
Now that I've drawn your teeth, Piper, fight if you can.
Given a few days off, after distinguishing himself at La Rochelle, D'Artagnan met up with his friends at an inn. Being sent a message by Athos that they had something of importance to tell him.
It appears everyone is on a holiday today and we might soon get into an argument.
Well, Ayo, you men have been pretty active.
Well, yes, we have taken a bastion.
Which one?
The bastion Saint Germain.
What were the losses?
5 men on our side and 8 or 10 on the Rochellians.
It is probable that the Rochellians will send boxmen to repel the bastion.
Yes, that is possible.
Gentlemen, a bet.
Ah, yes, a bet.
What will it be? I will bet you that my companions and I will have breakfast at St. Jovi and stay there for an hour, no matter what the enemy might do.
What is the bet?
You are 4, we are 4. We must get unlimited dinner for it.
That is fair.
Thank you.
course and stay a full hour and a half at the bastion. They were once assaulted by some workers and four soldiers were easily repulsed. Then by a regiment, which was designated by accurate musket fire and a clever collapsing of a wall upon them. And finally, by an entire unit. The intrepid musketeers, having won the battle, left as unit advanced, delaying the unit's attack by propping up dead bodies with muskets and disabling the soldiers. The real reason for breakfasting at the bastion was for Athos, Corporal Satya of Milady's murderous design, and to hand over her advance pardon to Dakar.
Here is juicy chicken! Tasty, tasty fruits! So here we are at the bastion!
My dear Athos, do tell me, where are we?
We are at bastion and we are here to have our breakfast.
But why not have breakfast here?
Because we have a very important thing to tell Dathya. At least no one will interrupt us here.
We have made a bet. To win it, we must remain in bastion for an hour. The blastless attack. You are capable of rebel putting in the bastion. The musket examination will still be there. And with that much firepower, we may be able to defend ourselves if we are attacked by the enemy.
Now I hope you are going to tell me the secret.
Well, I saw the lady last night and she demanded the cardinal to take your head. And the cardinal gave her pardon letter in advance. And also, the lady is going to England to assassinate the Duke.
What? That's outrageous!
We must inform the Queen of that plot.
Well, there is another solution. The lady has a brother-in-law in England, Lord de Winter. We'll tell him that his sister-in-law plans to assassinate the Duke and tell him to keep an eye on her and detain her from protecting the Duke.
I think in short, we should inform both of them at the same time. We must write the letters and punch to them.
By the whole camp. The commotion was so great that the cardinal thought a riot was taking place. The four won the bet by staying at bastion for 1 hour. The cardinal heard of the exploits of four brave men and wanted them on his side. Time was to pass before this took place. However, time in which the musketeers with D'Artagnan tried and executed Lady de Winter for her crimes, for she had also killed Constance, whom D'Artagnan loved. And then, one day, when they returned to Paris, the cardinal had D'Artagnan arrested for conspiring against the King of France.
Monsieur, you have been arrested upon my orders.
So I am told, Monsieur.
You know why?
No, Monsieur, but the crimes I have really committed is still unknown to your Eminence.
What? You have committed crimes of which I do not know?
I certainly have. If your Eminence mistake the crimes of which I am accused, I shall soon defend them and confess to the ones I have made.
You are charged with having corresponded with the enemies of the kingdom. You are charged with having surprised state secrets. You are charged with having tried to thwart the plans of your general.
Are these charges brought by a woman branded by the taxes of the country? Married one man in France and one in England. Poisoned the second husband and sought to poison and stab me to death?
What? If these charges are true, she will be tried and punished.
She has already been tried, already been punished by death.
And Dathya told the cardinal of the wicked misdeeds of Milady. How she poisoned her own husband, how she poisoned Constance, and how she tried thrice to murder Dathya himself.
So, you've appointed yourselves judge, jurors and executioners. You shall be tried.
In which case, I must tell you, I have a pardon in my pocket.
Your pardon? From whom?
From your Eminence.
From me? I have given no such pardon to you.
Not to me, perhaps, but you did give one to my lady. And the terms of the pardon are sufficient to get me off the hook.
December 3rd, 1627. It is by my order and for the good of the state that the bearer of this has done what he has done. The Shell you card.
lost. Your Eminence bears up my evidence.
Take it, young man.
I am a wounded musketeer, a lieutenant.
Your Eminence, this is no jealous.
You four brave soldiers love each other so much, should serve in the same company. I was happy to hear about your adventure at the Bastion today. I've been observing you closely, Monsieur D'Artagnan, and I'm proud to invite you to become a musketeer.
Thanks, Your Eminence. My dreams have come true. Athos, your idea was great. We achieved glory as well as being able to hold a very important position.
All for one, one for all.
La Rochelle surrendered after a year-long siege, and D'Artagnan took up his promotion as a musketeer with an appointment signed by no less than the cardinal, and his dream to become a musketeer and serve the king became true.
Fighting and in
Hello, class 7. So, Yashab. Salvandya. Salvatuna. Nirvi. Krishna. Harsh. Sina. Ali Hamza. Ashwin. Yana. Anushree. Mahi. Tanisha. Alicia. Tanishka. Palak. Prabal. Kush. Garth. Janhi. Mohit. Rachit. Aditya. Arjita. Mantha. Arindam. Sakina. Shravani. Ritu. Somya. Vishnu. Sharani. Yuri. Julie. Pratham. Niti. Neha. Arta. Sara. Kavya. Ananya. Aditya. I am saved. Not missed out. So,
Sindh Gujarat.